Today we'll be making sodium carbonate, which is also known as washing powder or soda ash. It is very similar to sodium bicarbonate or baking soda. There are some main differences between them, as in baking soda is used to cook and washing powder is generally used to clean and even in soap making. Luckily, it's extremely easy to do and all we need is baking soda, a heat source, and a pot. I like to make large amounts of sodium carbonate at one time because I have used it in many of my upcoming extractions, from caffeine of the Death Wish coffee to making copper carbonate. We turn on our heat source at around 200 degrees Fahrenheit. We will stir the baking soda around to provide even drying. Eventually, when the baking soda is hot enough, we can see that little geysers begin to form as I run my glass rod through them. This is the baking soda releasing the carbon dioxide and water. Once heated, the baking soda turns into washing powder, carbon dioxide, and water. Eventually, the little geysers will stop, but it is important to keep heating for around 10 more minutes. This is to ensure that all the water is released. Over time, washing soda decomposes to form sodium oxide, releasing the carbon dioxide. Warmer conditions can speed up the decomposition process. Once cooled, we have our washing powder. We will now label and store it for future use.